Hey friends, welcome back to Xblogs. Today is a very quick snack called the Punjabi Samosa. Come, let's see how it can be made. If you are a first-time viewer, then do subscribe to our channel and show us some support. We will begin with making the dough first. For this I have taken maida or all-purpose flour, 3 cups. A teaspoon of salt. A teaspoon of ajwain or carom seeds. You can also add zeera in this. 3 heaped tablespoons of ghee. Mix the dough well until all the ingredients have combined well. If your dough is falling apart, you can add a little more of oil or ghee to this mixture. Start adding water as required to form a very tight dough. Once a nice tight dough is formed, knead the dough for a minimum of 5 to 10 minutes. Grease and cover with a damp towel and allow to rest for a minimum of half an hour. Moving on to making the Punjabi samosa filling, here I'm adding ghee 2 tablespoons to a pan, half a teaspoon of zeera. Next, I'm adding 4 medium-sized boiled and peeled potatoes. You can also add boiled green peas to this mixture. A teaspoon of salt. 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. 1/4 teaspoon of zeera powder. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. A teaspoon of chaat masala, 2 green chilies chopped, and lastly coriander half a cup chopped. Mix everything well until all the ingredients combine. Leave a few sized chunks of the potato because we want the bite in it. Simmer on low flame until the raw smell of the masala has gone. It took about 5 minutes for me. So our filling is ready, we will allow this mixture to cool down. So our dough has rested well for approximately half an hour. Now I'm going to knead the dough again for approximately another 5 minutes. Take a small size portion and grease with oil on both the sides. Roll into a thick sheet, give it a moment to shrink back and roll again to the desired size. This will yield me 2 samosas, so I'm making a cut in the center. Apply water on the edge. Carefully lift and shape it into a cone. Stick the sides well. Place it in your hand and fill it with a generous amount of the filling. A Apply water on the edges and seal it. Place it down and press gently so it forms into a nice samosa shape. Similarly, make others as well. The dough and the filling yielded me approximately 12 to 13 samosas. We will move on to the frying part. To a large pan, I have added enough oil so the samosas are immersed. Heat the oil to a high temperature, then lower the flame and add the samosas carefully one by one. Frying on low to medium flame for at least 10 to 15 minutes. As the layer of this samosa is thick, it takes time to cook thoroughly. So make sure you fry it on low to medium flame until nice, crispy and golden brown. Keep splashing oil and turning it on particular intervals. Once nice and crispy and golden brown, remove on a paper towel and serve hot with green chutney or meaty chutney. The recipe for the chutneys will be shared in the description box below. Do try this easy and amazing snack at your home and let us know how it turned out. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye-bye.